Hello to all my friends out there. So I'm working around the house today and I want to make myself some stuffed biscuits. So you might be thinking, what's with these stuffed biscuits? Well, I have a lot of biscuits in the stockpile and I just like biscuits. So what I have here is I had some HelloFresh hamburger, some garlic and pepper seasoning, some carrots, some celery out of my garden, and some dry onions. So what I want to do is create a little hamburger filling. So I thought this is something you want to stockpile. I think we better get a case or two. So I don't want it too runny because I'm going to stuff a biscuit with it. But I want a little tomato in there, you know, it tastes good. I'm going to make it like a Mexican hamburger filling. It can be anything you want. A little bit more, not too much, because I don't want it to run out of my biscuit. So now I have a little taco seasoning. This stuff goes forever. I've made all kinds of stuff out of this. This is actually a lot of filling. I don't know how many biscuits this is going to make, but I will make them all up, and then if I don't eat them, I will just freeze them for later. I wanted to do this video, not this particular video, but a video where I make the biscuits. Everybody has their own method. You could make this with canned biscuits. But it's not as easy to store canned biscuits long term. So, you know, that's why I usually go for the biscuit mix. Okay, so let's see. Now, okay, so here is the garlic. I bought this garlic pepper at Dollar Tree and the onions and the tomato sauce and the taco seasoning. So that's what's in the meat. Gotta be careful not to burn the meat. It's just really gonna ruin the whole thing if I burn the meat. But I wanna heat it up to season, you know, to get my seasoning in there good. Okay, so I have 1 cup of biscuit mix. So if you can see, I had for one big biscuit, 1/2 cup mix and 1/6 cup milk. But usually I have to add a little bit more. So what I have here is evaporated milk. 1/2 evaporated milk, 1/2 water, 1 cup each. So this is gonna make really good biscuits. So in this biscuit mix, all you add is milk. So this would be one of those times that if you wanted to make something like this and you didn't have any milk, powdered milk, first of all, it's a good idea to stockpile that. You could use coffee creamer, you know, just add a 1/3 cup coffee creamer. It's better than nothing. So I try not to over stir. What I'm doing is I'm wetting my dough. That's all I'm doing. I don't want to manhandle it or my biscuits might be. So now I just add a little bit at a time. My biscuits might be tough, so they're not going to taste as good. If see how this part of the biscuit mix is wet, this goes for if you're making it homemade, same thing. And if you get a little bit more too much, you can correct that when you roll them out. So now it's starting to wet good, but I still want a little wetter than that. Ooh. I'm at a very clumsy angle here. So, this is kind of really wet, but that's okay. I'll show you in a minute. So, I'm just, you know, turning around and not manhandling my dough. That's good. Okay. I find that biscuit mix to be good. I think I'm going to buy a big, big bag at Smart and Final this week. I'm going to go through the stockpile. You know, I have a lot of stuff. But it, so now I want to make a little like a pot pie, like a Hot Pocket, but my own Hot Pocket. Your own's going to be better. It's too big. Okay. So I want to make like a little boat to put my filling in. These will bake up into a nice biscuit, so. Right. You know, use your creative license, whatever you like. So I want to put a generous amount of filling in my biscuit. And then I have Hello Fresh cheese left. You know, they gave you 4 meals for a week. But it was a lot. It really was. Okay, now I want to make like a little top. So you don't want to overhandle your biscuit mix. That would be a big mistake. Because then they're going to be tough. Okay, so it's looking good. You could put a little. Okay, now what I do when I make biscuits is I have some oil. And what I want to do is carefully put the biscuit in, and then I want to carefully flip it. Ay-yi-yi. I better do a little patching here. And then just flip it over and then bake it at 400. So I'm gonna make the rest of my filling. I'm gonna bake them up and then I will show you on my thumbnail. Okay, you guys, please like, comment, and subscribe, and God bless you all.